to take you down to Pine Ridge for another visit with Lum and Abner. Brought to you by the makers of Horlicks, the original malted milk. Trying all week to get started, Lum and Abner finally got their rolling grocery store in operation today. The motor, which was being overhauled yesterday, is in working order. The shelves have been rearranged so that the merchandise will not fall out while the store is in motion. And they left early this morning determined to make a complete canvas of the town. As we look in on Pine Ridge now, we find Grandpappy Spears over at Dick Huddleston's store discussing Lum and Abner's new business venture. Listen.
They must have got the engine fixed, for they never had that team of horses pulling it hog over.
Oh, yeah, they got the motor back in there now. It's working fine when they left here this morning.
And they're sure doing the business with it. They're stopping at every house along the road. I believe everybody's buying from them, too.
Well, that's good. I'm glad to hear.
It's a handy thing at all. Now, like this morning, I was just fixing to come to town here to buy a bunch of stuff down here from you, and they'd give up that fund, and sure, I just went out there and bought it off of them. I knowed I wouldn't have to pack it so far that way.
No. Well, I think it'll do a big business at first. It's something new, you know. Naturally, everybody will want to try it out.
I just wish to goodness I'd have thought up the idea myself. It'd have been the very thing for me.
Oh, it sounds like a good idea, all right. Wait, I'll leave that in my room.
Yeah, come on, go ahead.
Huddleston's store? Yes, ma'am. Why, neither one of them's here right now, Miss Wilkins, but they usually come in most every day. Uh-huh. Yes, ma'am. All right, I'll tell them. Goodbye. That's a lot of nerve for you. One of my customers calling up wanting me to tell Lum and Abner to stop by her place in the morning so she won't start doing her trading with them.
Well, I do know. Well, I reckon there'd be a lot of them quitting you now, Richard. You may as well make up your mind for that.
Yeah, well, I expect my business to fall off for a while, but after the new wears off of it, why, they'll come back.
Well, I hope they do make a success of it. We've had awful hard run of luck here lately.
There's that phone again. Losing another customer, I guess. Hello? Yes, ma'am? Well, I know they're not right now. They ought to be back before long. The contest. Why, just mail it to Lum and Abner. Yes, ma'am. Why, sure I'd send it in. You stand just as good a chance as anybody else to win one of those prizes. What? Well, that sounds like a good one, all right. Yeah, I hope you win. All right, Miss Phillips. Not at all. Goodbye. If you just thought up a name for the store and didn't know how to send it to
them. Oh, wait a minute. That just reminds me, too. I studied up a name last night. I thought it'd be a good one for that store.
Well, I'd sure send it in, Grandpa.
Oh, I aim to, yeah.
No telling what kind of a name those judges like the best, you know. That money they're giving for prizes would come in mighty handy.
Yeah, it's your word to me right now. I just don't know how I'm going to get by, hardly.
Well, if so many of those prizes, the fellas stand an awful good chance of winning one of them.
Oh, yeah. And it's right smart of fun studying up names for a contraption like that. I know I have.
Oh, yeah, there's a new store driving up there in front now.
Yeah, I reckon they made the rounds here.
Yeah. Now, they were talking about driving over some of these other towns around here and working them. Why, they'll have plenty of time to do that if they can get through this early every day.
Oh, I think they mean to go to Cherry Hill tomorrow, Lum said.
Well, come in, Abner.
How'd you do, Abner?
How'd you do, Grandpa?
I said, how did you do with your store today?
Oh, fine, fine. Done uncommonly there.
Yeah.
Where's Lum?
Why, he's out there in the store. He's counting up the money we're taking in today.
Did a nice business, huh?
Oh, we've just done fine. I think we sold something all the way we stopped. You fellas ain't doing enough business to put me to work on that area. Well, I don't know. You'll have to see Lum about that, Grandpa. He plenty put all right today, but he sure kept us a jumping. Folks never bought much, but might not all of them bought something.
Yeah.
I believe in a few days they'll be giving us all their business.
I do know.
Well, there's not a whole lot of cash in town right now, Edmund, and won't be till after crops are gathered. Why, Skunk just about cleaned this town out selling cotton and silver mine around here.
Yeah, we heard a lot of complaints about that today. A lot of them jumping on Lum about it, on him being the president of the company.
Yeah, I was afraid Lum was making a mistake taking that office.
Yeah, well, as far as trouble was, you know, Richard, they promised that we'd get dividends for this time, and so far we just ain't got nothing. Well, Lum was telling all today to wait till Squire gets back from Arizona. Told him that he was out there to sell it, and if he did, why, we'd all do this. Yeah, I guess that one fella's already offered him over $1 million for the mine.
Well, I wouldn't spend any money on a sense of that, Grandpap. I think that fella Worthington, that came in here and made that offer, was just a fake.
Fake?
Yes.
No, he weren't neither. No, sir, I was down there at the stockholders' meeting whenever Mr. Worthington got right up on his feet and said he'd give us $1 million cash, sir.
Yeah, I know he made that offer all right, but that doesn't mean that he would have paid it.
Oh, you think he was trying to fool Squire, huh?
No, I think the Squire was trying to fool everybody else here in town. I can't be sure yet, but I'd almost bet that Squire had that fellow Worthington come in here and make that offer just to get the stockholders more enthused over the silver mine, so that he could sell them all more stock.
Well, there's reason, all right. Well, I don't know whether it was done a purpose or not, but that's just what happened. Every last one of them just went hog wild, put every nickel they could get their hands on.
We put it all around to the back, Cedric, and we'll load it up again. There, gentlemen, gentlemen.
Well, come in, Lum. Abner was just saying he had a big day.
Oh, my, there's ain't no doubt in my mind now. This rolling store is a success. Taking in $62.30 today.
Well, for goodness sake, I never had no idea he'd done that.
Oh, that is fine.
What are you limping about there, Lum?
Huh?
What are you limping
oh,
about?
Oh, nothing. Nothing to speak of. Just had a little accident. You just take that right up, Abner.
Yeah, Lum fell off of the store. While it was running? Yeah.
Well, how'd you do that, Lum?
Well, it sounds awful silly to tell, but I was sitting back there on the porch in that rocking chair while we was driving along, and we passed old Uncle Henry Lunsford along the road there. His horse got the shine at the store, so I just stepped off the porch there to help hold his horse for him and turned about four somersets. I forgot we was moving. You see, I used to porches running down the road there.
Well, that's a shame.
Oh, it ain't nothing. Just sort of twisted my ankle a little. I'd be willing to break a leg to do that kind of business every day.
I reckon how much we'll make out of that, Mom.
Well, I've done got it all figured up here, Abner. I see. We made, according to my figures here, $15.57, clear profit.
Well, good. Now, let's see, that's how much a piece is that?
Well, I've got that figure, too. $7.77.5 a piece.
Well, what do you know about that? Just for one day's work.
Why, sure.
Well, now, wait a minute, Lum. Have you deducted all your expenses on that?
Well, that's just it. We don't have no expenses. That's the advantage of a rolling store on wheels. Yeah. Don't have no taxes or store rent to pay and such as that.
Yeah, but you've got the dressing and oil is on the top.
Oh. Yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
I forgot about that. How much was that gas and oil we got when we started out this morning, Adam, over at Frank Foster?
Oh, that's cool. I had it. Car, large, but I got a slip back there. That is for a funny. Yeah. $3.30.
Well, that'll have to come off there.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
Well, let's see. That's $3.30 off of $15.57.
And you got to take off what you're paying Frederick.
Well, we just pay Frederick once a week, though.
Yeah, but you'll have to figure that in on your expenses every day, though, won't
you? Yeah, I guess that's right. Well, that's $1.50 more off of
it. I'm just looking on this bill here, too, Lum. There's that tire we had to buy this morning, $10.50.
Tire? Oh, yeah. How much was that?
$10.50. Don't you know Frank took our old one in for $2, said that he could balkanize that place where we cut it on that old broke street jar.
Yeah, that sort of seems to lift the thing, then. According to these figures, that don't leave us but 27 cents profit. So you fellas just hack up and don't try to steady up nothing else. We got to dust off of there. First thing we know, we'll be going.
Well, those fellows may not be making much money with their store on wheels, but think of the business they're doing. Lum and Abner and Horace. We now bid you all goodbye until tomorrow at the same time.